Okay, well, find a comfortable posture to settle in. And last week we talked about the ease of rigor to some extent, and we'll continue to elaborate a little bit on that idea as a way of practice. That at some point, the threshold of vigor and enthusiasm and seekerhood that we're putting into our awakening process, it's like a handoff. Gary always said, for as much as you're trying to wake up and return, the universe is pulling you in with infinite more effort than you are reaching. And when I was first practicing, it didn't matter. I was like, just gritting my teeth as many minutes as I could, trying to sit quietly. Sounds funny now when I look back on it. But it made sense. Because there was a lack of knowledge, there was a lack of understanding of that force that is pulling us in. I thought, well, if it wasn't on my own merit, no way was my thoughts ever going to slow down. And I do think that is very much applicable, but only to some extent. And then at some extent, we hand off the effort. We have to evaluate that handoff process, because some people are like, great. And they're ready to do that maybe a little prematurely. And so then their mind just continues to drive them crazy. How do you know when it's time to hand off the sense of effort? Part of that aspect is that it continues to remain joyful and interesting. When we need to effort or feel like we're efforting, it's because everything else that's an option to us feels like torture. To leave it alone is too intense. So we need to take some will, control our breath, watch our thoughts. And then it really works. We get really good at it. It works. And at some point, you can maybe just start to be here and enjoy this hour, 50 minutes, 45 minutes, whatever it's going to be. Just enjoy spending some time. With no necessary goal in mind or vision for what you're here to achieve or accomplish. But that this in itself is actually kind of nice. It's not flashy. Not going to get praise for it. Little badge, put on your shirt, sticker. But just the act of being here, it's kind of nice. Quiet with friends or sitting in your own. When you have enough circumstance, just as this moment is, to really steep in that appreciation. It's kind of like gratitude, but it's really more of an appreciation for being yourself, for being this moment. That there is plenty happening right now that can hold your interest. Instead, if it's not interesting enough, as a matter of fact, it's difficult or unsettling, then you want to bring a little bit of will into your practice, counting your breath, watching your thoughts, using a phrase like we often do. But for right now, let's just check in. Perhaps you are at one of those moments where you can hand off the effort. As you hand off the effort, you find that sitting here, the body's doing okay. The emotions are doing okay. And the thoughts, they come and go too. Not so bad. This idea of appreciation has this quality of contentment within it. as the awareness passes through, passes around, whether it's thoughts or emotions or body sensations, you may even follow them for a moment. Wherever it goes, wherever it arrives at, it's not too bad. Nice. Some of those thoughts may be actually helping you understand something. There's no need to make anything go, make anything arrive, stay. Big need for a mystical aha of the self is here. The self is here. It's the most mundane thing you could imagine. It can't not be here. Which means in the dregs of boredom, the self is here. And in the heights of ecstasy, self is here. If you're ready to make the handoff, you don't care. Dregs or boredom, heights of ecstasy. Self is here. I'm good either way. So as things pass through awareness, there's this appreciation for whatever arises. If you can't find that appreciation, you really want things to change, then you put some effort in, count the breath, some affirmation. Another chunk of time here. Perhaps you don't need a practice. You're just enjoying your sit. The only thing that could bother you is your perception of you. And just let the thoughts, let the feelings, let the body sensations run their course. So long as you can tolerate it, maybe you can even enjoy it. It might be difficult, but there's an enjoyment in what those thoughts reveal. They might reveal what you crave, desire. It might reveal what you worry about, what you're afraid of. What you crave and what you're afraid of is based on what we would say is false. A false perception of yourself. It's not the real you. It's a perception of you. If you don't like it and you want to change it, then you can spend some time looking at it, realizing that craving, that worry is based on a false perception of myself. You don't have to go too deep on the tank. You just remember that next time it comes around. That worry, that craving is based on a false perception of myself. If you remember that, next time that worry or craving comes around, you might get a chance to say, oh yeah, that perception of myself, that's not me. I'm right here. I'm right here. Right here, it's just fine. Don't have to short circuit or go hunt it down. Just the next time you find yourself washed away in a worry or a craving, a desire or a fear, just remember, it's based on a perception, a false perception of yourself. Then you might get a chance to see it, to see that false perception. It's actually kind of a nice feeling when it happens. If it doesn't arise, you've got nothing to do. That's a nice feeling as well. Remember, any worry, any craving stems from a false perception of yourself. Can you see it? Can you see the I that you think you are? A little me that you made up inside your head. If you can't see it for yourself, you can believe it. There's a craving or a worry, a fear or a desire. It's causing you some difficulty, suffering. It's because of a false I. And perhaps you can just see beyond it. Remember that right now, you don't need the words to describe it, but right now, your sit is quite nice. No one needs anything from you. You don't need anything. There's an appreciation to it, a contentment. You don't have to go hunting. You hand off the effort. Part of handing off the effort is trusting who you're handing it off to. The real I, the real thing, you, the real you, doesn't experience effort the same way. No wonder the false I has to try so hard. The false I tries so hard because it's incapable. The real I makes everything happen. Really sit and appreciate, to feel contented, is to know that deep in your heart. The real I is taking care of business. Your business. Notice how everything was being taken care of. At this moment, it stayed together without the false I having to effort. Perhaps the body could move, the words could speak, the eyes could look, the thoughts could think. Without the effort of the false I. The deep appreciation, contentment comes when we know this. That's how we hand it off. The real I does not effort, it just does. Don't overthink it. Don't try too hard. Don't force it or effort. It's already happening. It's always happening. Rest. Feel how supported this moment is beyond the effort of the false I. Don't tell me that it's all good and great while we're doing our sitting practice. Really understand it during sitting practice, so that you may endeavor to take it into the other areas of your life. Understand how held this moment is, how taking care of this very moment, not some future or past moment that you need to concoct in your mind. This very moment is completely supported without the effort of the false I. See if you see that. Are you willing to see that? It's still that way right now, too, huh? And now? It's nice. One can appreciate, even if it's just a few moments when you're sitting, a few moments of no effort from the false I. Relax. And perhaps endeavor to see how far into the next moments, the next aspects of your life, the false eye does not need to effort.